Wicked Witch of the West. I recently spoke with these two talented performers about their journey into the world of Oz.
They're buildings tall as clocks with trees, dress salons, libraries, palaces, museums, 100 strong. There are wonders like I've never seen. It's all green, it's all green. I think we found the place where we belong. I wanna be in this hoi polloi. So I'll be back for good someday to make my life and make my way. But for today, we'll wander and enjoy.
Welcome, witches. We have, just to make some introductions, on my left, we have Kristen Chenoweth, Glinda, the Good Witch, and Idina Menzel, Elphaba, the Wicked Witch of the West. Now, actually, I think people might be wondering, Elphaba, I think there's an interesting derivation for that name.
Yes, it is the author's name of the book called The Wizard of Oz, L. Frank Baum.
Yeah. So anyway, for folks who are not familiar with what Wicked is, do you want to explain just in a kind of in a nutshell what the story is and what's going on with your characters?
It's a story of the two witches from The Wizard of Oz, Glinda, the Good Witch of the North, and Elphaba, who turns out to be the Wicked Witch of the West. And it's the story of their friendship from when they're young girls in Shiz University,
right,
where they meet through up until the time you sort of meet them in the movie and afterwards.
Yeah. And it's a lot of things that fans of The Wizard of Oz wouldn't expect about these characters. I know, Kristen, you were saying to me on opening night that when you were a kid and you would watch The Wizard of Oz, you always thought, you know, what's up with that Glinda? There's something going on there. She's not probably as nice as she seems.
That's kind of what I wanted to show in this character, is that behind the facade of the beauty and the plasticness, there was a real person there with lots of issues, a good person, and also one that struggled with jealousy and envy, and you know, but yet she wants to take her under her wing and be friends. So yeah, I mean, I always looked at, especially I thought Billy Burke was really good in the way she portrayed that character, but it always did make me wonder, is that real? Is she real?
Mm-hmm. But do you guys have special personal connections to your characters? I know I was reading how Joe Mantello, the director, was saying how you are sort of like your characters to begin with.
Oh, and did he?
Oh, I hope not.
What did he say? And just that you are much more sort of the way you work. You're very methodical, mm-hmm, and you will mull things over, mm-hmm, and you come out more, you know, you'll sort of go for the spotlight more quickly or something like that, I guess, in your method of,
yes,
delving into a character.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Do you guys feel that, it seems like these parts were written for you. Do you feel that way?
Yeah. We've worked on them and helped develop them for several years now. So I think when you do get the wonderful opportunity of originating a role and working with the composer and the director and the book writer, mm-hmm, you, there starts to have that uncanny, you know, merging of, mm-hmm, the person and the character.
And are there aspects of your life that you draw on? Another thing I was reading, which was interesting, I know you're sort of you were in the beauty pageant circuit,
mm-hmm, yeah,
in your younger days.
I
you
was.
Were a runner-up to Miss Oklahoma.
I was first runner-up to Miss Oklahoma, yeah.
And you were saying that you based some of Glinda on some of your fellow contestants.
You bet. I mean, I'm sure there are aspects of Glinda that I relate to personally, but there's a couple of girls I'm thinking of as I make up this character who will remain nameless. You know, for example, I remember one time in the top 10 swimsuit competition, right before I walked out, a girl that ended up winning said to me, "Have you gained weight this week?" And I said, "They actually told me to." So, you know, I actually learned a lot through that and have been able to draw on it in this character.
I'll show you what shoes to wear, how to fix that hair, everything that really counts to be popular. I'll help you be popular. You'll hang with the right cohorts, you'll be good at sports, know the slang you've got to know. So let's start, cause you've got an awfully long way to go.
Now, did you guys have, you know, so many people have these incredible relationships with The Wizard of Oz, the movie. You know, I know me, I was making my mother call up the network to say, when is it going to be on? Did you guys have special relationships with
it? Yeah, I mean, I loved watching the movie. People ask me this question now a lot, and, you know, what were you scared of or what did you like? And I was that music would come on with Margaret Hamilton when she'd be on the bicycle, then on the monkeys, and it was it does bring up a eerie feeling, and I guess that's why I love playing this role now, because people come in the audience with that preconceived notion of who she is, and then we burst on the scene and we're in these student outfits and have a smile from ear to ear, hoping that this college experience is going to be different, and so it just gives us such a big range and to play with, and and I like just kind of, you know, deconstructing those walls that people, those ideas that people are coming into the theater with.
And so it will be for the rest of my life. I want nothing else till I die. Held in such high esteem. When you see me, they will scream. For Hasselhoff's favorite team. The Wizard. Hello!
What about the green? How long does it take you to get that off?
To get it off? Alec Baldwin was there last night, and I had never met him, and I'm, you know, a fan, and he's a good-looking guy, and I was in the shower like, get this off, I don't want to meet him in this green makeup on. And I was just digging the towel, like, scratching my skin.
Were you nervous the first time you put it on that this is never going to come off?
Because we have to spray it with a waterproof spray so that it doesn't rub off on Kristen or Norbert, and sweatiness and crying and things like that. So actually, it takes like 10 minutes to get off the proper cleansers, but it's all good.
She's
and fun.
She's got it down pat.
Yeah. She's come in and caught me in the shower with shower cap on, looking like the old lady with the green face, rinsing off.
This is going down the drain.
It's the blackmail right there.
Good thing I love you.
We are out of time, but thank you so much for coming in.
Oh, thank you.
It is Wicked at the Gershwin Theater. Thanks so much.
Thank you.
And by the way, there will soon be some real-life on-stage romance in Wicked. A few days after we taped that interview, it was announced that Idina Menzel's husband, actor Taye Diggs, will be joining the show for a few weeks. From December 25th through January 20th, Diggs will be filling in for Norbert Leo Butz in the role of the love interest, Fiero. Butz is currently on medical leave from the show due to a back injury. Now, this will not be the first time Menzel and Diggs have shared the stage. They met for the first time when they starred together in the original Company of Rent. And a few seasons back, they appeared together in the Manhattan Theater Club's production of The Wild Party. Okay, it is time for...